riders heading out onto the racetrack, and this is race number three. So we've got Rinfret, Pierce, Valancourt, Fair, Holden, Cote, and Stenke, Anflick, Holding, William, and Renshaw, Morrill, Guthrie, and Nichols, Webb, Laporte, Hodgson, and Hellam, Stevenson, King, Taylor, Henry, Murray, Jones, and Allen, and rounding out the field, it is Rapa. Excited to be here in this race. Who comes around first from the sighting lap? It is the 210. Wins the sighting lap. Well, I think it's 270, to be honest with you. It's hard to read that, but that would be Chris Fair, and he's lined up on the front row on the outside. All these riders trying to keep the bikes good and warm, trying to keep the tires warm. That's a big deal. On a day like today, when the breeze can take the heat out of the tires, you'll set it on warmers, but then you've got to come up to the grid. And of course, we can't always predict just how long it's going to take to put the motorcycles on the racetrack. And with a track like this, you're going so far and so long that you do tend to have to be careful about the temperature of the tires. Set up. And we're ready to go. And here we go. Let's go racing. We're off and running right from the start. Got a whole lot of movements going up through the middle of the field. Rinfret got a good start. Pierce got a good run. And it looks like Chris Fair got a good run down the hill. Now we'll try and pick them up as they work their way around. But we won't really be able to see the numbers until they come out of the front straight. They rocket up that slight incline. They'll be dropping into turn number two momentarily. Lots of passing opportunities on this racetrack. It's good and wide. I mean, they've driven Indy cars here. They've driven all kinds of race cars. So it's like an open field for some of the racers, especially those who race at some of the other tracks in Ontario that aren't quite as wide on the pavement. In most of our tracks here in Ontario, inclines are very difficult to find because a lot of them are built on old air bases or on other flat ground. This particular track, built in, I believe, 61, 62, I was 2 years old. Anyway, has become one of the most challenging tracks all through North America. Mario Andretti considered it the most challenging track he'd ever raced on. And it is Daniel Rinfret in the lead. He's followed by Jody Pierce, our third place rider. is a 28 of Valancourt. And I believe right up there in the mix already might be Dan Henri on the 153. Normally 176, but I can see the 76, and if I've got this right, he's actually on a 125 Grand Prix bike. So staying up in the mix on that bike in this group is quite an achievement. Mark Murray coming around, as I mentioned yesterday, he's wearing what we call the rookie vest, and that's just a way of showing the other riders that he is new to this sport. Finding his way around and give him a little extra space. Don't go by him so close at such a high speed that you turn him backwards. And as I mentioned yesterday, another rookie rider had his vest on and it was basically shredding as he rode down the track, so I would figure that he's been very close to the point where he can take off the remnants of that vest because he's left most of it around the racetrack anyway. That means he's going fast enough that he's no longer a rookie. Red Brett comes around another time. Jody Pierce has set off trying to chase him down, but at this point, the gap is widening. Valancourt is leading Daniel, or Dan Henry, on the 153, so that's your top four. Moro's under attack from, I believe, a 126, if I got that number right. Difficult to see at some points. I don't think it is a 126. And that 125cc GP bike is cutting through traffic like I did not expect to see.
Town Moto and period 1 250s. This is your first call.
number 17. Your first call. We're at halfway on this one. Talk about the access that fans have to motorcycle racers and their bikes, and a chance to walk through the pits, not getting blocked and not being told to stay away. If you get a chance to see some of these race bikes with their bodywork off and the engineering that's been done to keep them running, they keep them true to their period that they come from. But there is a lot of situations, particularly the older bikes, that you just can't get parts for them. You know, sometimes somebody's got a whole store of original parts that have never been used, still brand new in the box, but sometimes you've got to fabricate the parts yourself. And when I think about that, it always makes me think of the movie The Last Indian, about the gentleman from Down Under, well actually I believe from New Zealand, who basically kept rebuilding and reforming and resmelting his pistons and all the parts so that he could run this old bike. It wasn't The Last Indian, it was the Fastest Indian. Run this bike at Bonneville. And there are a lot of situations where the parts are being remanufactured by somebody in their shop, just making some parts. Well, I'm riding this bike, I need this part. Maybe so-and-so who's riding this kind of bike would also need that part. And make a few more. Speed consistently as this race has gone on. Rickrat takes another run past the start finish line, well on in the lead. Dave King on an RZ350, and here comes your second place rider, the 692 of Jody Pierce. And Henry on the 153 up on the curbing, trying to get every bit of speed he can out of that motorcycle. Unofficially, he's running in third place, and if you think about the fact that he started on row number 7, that's pretty spectacular. Some passes being made. Morrow, who earlier in the race was mixing it up a little farther to the front, has got a whole lot of challenge around him. Slower traffic, and the last lap flag comes out for Daniel Rickrat on the number 1 machine. Jody Pierce comes around in second all by himself. Riders in race number 17. Race number 17, period 1 open, period 1 350s by Town Moto, and period 1 250s. Your race is next. This is your second call. Second call, we're in the last lap of this race, so second call for race 17. Ryan Stevenson going by on that two-stroke machine, the 933. Some drafting going on coming up down the front straight. And yes, indeed, particularly with the headwind, you can do that. You can take advantage of the guy in front of you or your wind. The wind that's hitting you, tuck in behind him, and then at the, just as you drop into the corner, pop out, and it kind of slows the guy you were following down and gives you a little bit of a run up to get around. Coming onto the front straight for the final time, it is number one, Daniel Rindgren, and the checkered flag waves a little way back to the starter. Jody Pierce trying to work his way through some traffic. He wants to have a clear run of that flag, and he will cross the line in second. Dan Henry comes around on the 153. He's looking at third place. Checkered flag waves. Riders in race number 17, period 1 open, period 1 350 by Town Moto, and period 1 250. Your race is now, and this is your